My life's ambition is definitely opera. I'd like to make it my full-time career.
I can't go a minute without thinking about an aria or humming a tune. Opera's just everything.
I got serious about it, really, when I had a lesson with Simon O'Neill, New Zealand's great Howden tenor, and he said, well, you could probably make some money off your voice.
I have been singing seriously since I was about 16. You know, I have a pretty clear idea that's what I want to do.
Opera and classical music as a whole has taken over my entire life. I think about it, I sing it, it's within me every day.
Opera gives one a great opportunity to express something that we don't get to express usually in our day-to-day lives.
My name is Isabella Moore. I'm 23 years old. I'm a soprano, and I'm from Auckland, West Auckland represent. I went to the same school that Kiri Te Kanawa went to, St. Mary's College in Ponsonby. I decided to do my NCEA exams using my voice rather than an instrument. And part of it was I had to learn an aria, and my first aria I ever sang was O Mio Babbino Caro, from Gianni Schicchi by Puccini. I gave it a go, loved it. That's probably why opera, for me, became my thing.
I'm Oliver Saul, and I'm originally from Christchurch, and I am a tenor. My favourite early memory of singing is singing Black Dog by Led Zeppelin in the practice rooms at my high school. I was 12 or 13 with two of my friends and pretending that my voice was broken and doing the, hey, mama, with the way you move! I remember screaming that and thinking, this is pretty cool. It was the easiest thing I thought at the time to go on to university and do music and singing, and over those 4 years of undergraduate and postgraduate study, opera kind of started to slowly emerge in the distance as the kind of direction that we called a head in.
I'm Christian Thurston from Rotorua, and I am a high baritone. I got involved in opera from an early stage. My family is very opera-orientated. Did a lot of musicals as a kid, and that sort of got me on stage and singing and acting. To take it seriously, I think you need at least an hour of singing a day practice, and that doesn't include mental prep. So if you're doing translations of your arias or songs, that doesn't count as your hour of singing. That still counts as practice. So I try and tend to do at least an hour and a half to 2 hours a day of focused practice.
My name's Bianca Andrew. I'm 24 years old. I'm a mezzo-soprano, and I was born in Wellington, and I've lived there all my life. I never, ever thought that I would be singing opera, ever. I thought I was going to be either an archaeologist or an air hostess or a nun. Those three things. I'm serious. I discovered opera at the warehouse, and I walked in there, and I saw this CD, and it was a six-disc set for $5, and I had $5 pocket money. So I bought it immediately, and I, having no idea what classical music was. And the first thing that I heard when I put it on was the love duet from Puccini's opera, Madame Butterfly. I was so overwhelmed by how beautiful it was, and I couldn't believe that I had discovered it out of nowhere. And from that day on, I knew that I wanted to be involved with it somehow, and I just had to find a way of doing that.
My name is Edward Lawrenson. I'm a 25-year-old baritone from Auckland. A number of years ago, I got involved in opera when I was in my early teens. I was cast as Marius in Les Mis, and I thought I should take some singing lessons. And my intuition told me to go with classical technique to improve my musical theatre voice. Unfortunately, I started falling in love with opera, and so sort of have left the musical theatre behind and am now pursuing this.
My name is Benson Wilson. I am from South Auckland, and I am a baritone. Well, I first heard opera in seventh form at Havelock North High School. We were studying Madame Butterfly, and just all the emotions and just the drama that went on within Madame Butterfly made me feel like that's something cool that I want to be a part of. This Competition is very important to the beginning of my career. Just making it to the finals already, to me, is such a great achievement. And I think that the winner will go on to do great things. But not only that, all the finalists will go on to do great things. So it's very important to all of us as young classical singers.
Well, everyone's been telling us you're winners because you've made the final, but I actually genuinely feel that way. I haven't even played with the idea of winning. My competitors are all exceptionally talented and, you know, very top performers.
In 2012, I was a semi-finalist for the Lexus Song Quest. I think at that stage, I wasn't quite vocally ready. Being a finalist this year, I think I'm just much more in that zone, and I mean, I can't wait to sing, and I just feel like I'm definitely more ready.
This competition is quite prestigious in that I would be joining names like Te Rītahu Rhodes, Dame Kerry Te Kānawa, Dame Malvina Major,
Jonathan Lamalu, Te Rītahu Rhodes, the list goes on. And to have your name next to them is just an amazing feat. And also, the funding and the scholarship money you win, it's gonna help so much.
It's an honour, really, and I feel like I've come away with so much already just from this week of preparation with our judge, Catherine, and working with the orchestra. I've come away with so much richness and of experience already, so to win or to be placed would be incredible.
I've been astounded all week by the level of their talent, their musicianship, their musicality, by their ability to communicate, their receptiveness to any of the suggestions I've made, you know, in the spirit of trying to make what is marvellous even better. And I just wonder whether you realise in New Zealand how much fantastic world talent that you've got here. Talking to the other judges, Roddy McCann and Roxanne Hislop, we're agreed that, in fact, just being here in the final is the biggest prize of all. Every single one of these young singers, on one occasion or another, and sometimes more, over this week that I've been working with them, has made me want to cry. And that's my way of being touched. Now, who does that tonight remains to be seen. But every one of them would be a worthy winner. And they're all going to have fine international careers. Some of them are more advanced in their studies than others, but they've all got what it takes, which is credit to them and a credit to what's going on in New Zealand.
I guess for me, there's nothing much more exciting than seeing beautiful potential with all the possibilities that lie ahead of these extremely talented young people. And they've all got sensational voices, you know, that's a given. But it's that extra factor of communication, you know, where they draw you in and you enter their world, you know, and you feel the emotion of it all being transmitted to you, because it, you know, the music is so emotional. They're singing such great music.
They must have heart. They have to connect with the audience. And certainly there were singers this morning when I listened to the stage orchestral, and I had goosebumps, or I almost couldn't breathe during some of their arias because it was so beautiful, and they had brought me into the emotion of the piece. That's what I'm looking for. I guess it's the X factor.
The one criterion that will deliver the winner, the second place and the third place, is who actually touches our hearts. That sounds extremely cliched, but it is actually what makes music so remarkable.
My heart will probably be pumping really fast, usually to the tempo of the music, believe it or not, that started happening lately. I'll just try to be as centered as I can, and I just try and tell myself when when I start to freak out just before I step on stage, it's just, I'm okay as I am.
You're just waiting to do it. It's not a very fun environment, you know, in the waiting, so you're so ready for this thing. You've devoted a week to it.
Once that first phrase is out, you're not nervous because you're not you anymore, and you're also not in this world. You're creating a scene, so your focus is so much on other things that you don't have time to be nervous, really.
Definitely be a mixture of nerves and excitement. Singing with orchestra is so exciting that that excitement comes into it, but also it being a competition, there'll be nerves as well.
Please welcome Miss Isabella Moore. Please welcome Mr. Benson Wilson.
I am very happy with the way the orchestra played as well. It's just that spine tingling feeling where you just feel supported. It's amazing. It's an amazing experience. I loved it.
Yeah.
Please welcome Mr. Christian Thurston.
I'm very happy. You can relax. Oh, it's a big thing, but I think I got it. We'll see.
Opera's an instinctive thing, really. We spend a lot of time up here trying to make it, you know, better as the performer, but oftentimes I find it's actually when you just trust your gut and just say what you want to say that it sounds the best.
That'll be Mum.
Mr. Edward Laurenson.
Coltivando l'orgoglio di questo mentecatto. Tutto giovane raggiro. Speranza sola delle vendette mie, quest'anima consola e giubilar mi fai giubilar e giubilar mi fai giubilar e giubilar mi fa e giubilar mi fa.
That's quite a sensation, and that crowd after you're finished is just, you're not going to beat that for a long time, I don't think. I'll have to wait a while before I see a crowd like that, and a performance that means that much to me.
Third prize this evening goes to Christian Thurston. And the second prize this evening goes to Benson Wilson. And the winner is Isabella Moore.
Stop smiling, it's so awkward. I mean, I'd hoped, and I was, you know, I gave my best that I could, and I'm a bit speechless right now. I'm just really happy. It's such a great opportunity, and I mean, we get to sing in the town hall or, you know, with an orchestra, with not just any orchestra, the New Zealand Symphony Orchestra, and not many people get that opportunity. And so, I mean, thank you, Lexus.